Hello, and welcome to the Bible with Briscoe 2024. I am your messenger of the Word of God, Shenandoah Briscoe, and today we're going to be covering Genesis 27 through 28 and Matthew 8, 18 through 34. Father, I just ask for clarity of voice and articulation and a smooth reading of your Word, so that it may be a blessing to you and for all those who have tuned in from all around the world. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. And they all said, amen. Genesis 27. When Isaac was old, and his eyes were so weak that he could no longer see, he called for Esau, his older son, and said to him, "My son." "Here I am," he answered. Isaac said, "I am now an old man, and don't know the day of my death. Now then, get your equipment, your quiver and your bow, and go out to the open country to hunt some wild game for me. Prepare me the kind of tasty food I like, and bring it to me to eat, and so that I may give you my blessing before I die." Now Rebekah was listening as Isaac spoke to his son Esau. And when Esau left for the open country to hunt the game and bring it back, Rebekah said to her son Jacob, "Look, I overheard your father say to your brother Esau, 'Bring me some game and prepare me some tasty food to eat, so that I may give you my blessing in the presence of the Lord before I die.' Now, my son, listen carefully and do what I tell you. Go out to the flock and bring me two choice young goats, so I can prepare some tasty food for your father, just the way he likes it. Then take it to your father to eat, so that he may give you his blessing before he dies." And Jacob said to Rebekah his mother, "But my brother Esau is a hairy man, while I have smooth skin. What if my father touches me? I would appear to be tricking him and would bring down a curse on myself rather than a blessing." His mother said to him, "My son, let the curse fall on me. Just do what I say. Go and get them for me." And so he went and he got them, and he brought them to his mother, and she prepared some tasty food just the way his father liked it. Then Rebekah took the best clothes of Esau, her older son, which she had in the house, and put them on her younger son, Jacob. So she also covered his hands and the smooth parts of his neck with the goat skin. Then she handed her son, Jacob, the tasty food and the bread she had made. He went to his father, and he said, "My father." "Yes, my son," he answered. "Who is it?" And Jacob said to his father, "I am Esau, your firstborn. I have done as you told me. Please set up and eat some of my game, so that you may give me your blessing." Isaac asked his son, "How did you find it so quickly, my son?" "The Lord your God gave me success," he replied. And then Isaac said to Jacob, "Come near, so I can touch you, my son, to know whether you are really my son Esau or not." Jacob went close to his father Isaac, who touched him and said, "The voice is the voice of Jacob, but the hands are the hands of Esau." He did not recognize him, for his hands were hairy, like those of his brother Esau. So he proceeded to bless him. "Are you really my son Esau?" he asked. "I am," he replied. And then he said, "My son, bring me some of your game to eat, and so that I may give you my blessing." Jacob brought it to him, and he ate, and he brought some wine, and he drank. Then his father Isaac said to him, come here, my son, and kiss me. And so he went to him, and he kissed him. When Isaac caught the smell of his clothes, he blessed him and said, Ah, the smell of my son is like the smell of a field that the Lord has blessed. May God give you heaven's dew and earth's riches, and abundance of grain and new wine. May nations serve you and people bow down to you. Be Lord over your brothers, and may the son of your mother bow down to you. May those who curse you be cursed, and those who bless you be blessed. And after Isaac finished blessing him, and Jacob had scarcely left his father's presence, his brother Esau came in from hunting. He too prepared some tasty food, and he brought it to his father. And then he said to him, My father, please set up and eat some of my game, so that you may give me your blessing. His father Isaac asked him, Who are you? I am your son, he answered, your firstborn, Esau. Isaac trembled violently, and he said, Who was it then that hunted game and brought it to me? I ate it just before you came in, and I blessed him, and indeed he will be blessed. When Esau heard his father's words, he burst out with a loud and bitter cry, and he said to his father, bless me too, my father. But he said, Your brother came deceitfully and took your blessing. Esau said, Isn't he rightly named Jacob? This is the second time he has taken advantage of me. He took my birthright, and now he has taken my blessing too. Then he asked, Haven't you reserved any blessing for me? Isaac answered Esau, I have made him lord over you, and have made all his relatives his servants, and I have sustained him with grain and new wine. So what can I possibly do for you, my son? Esau said to his father, Do you have only one blessing, my father? Bless me too, my father. And then Esau wept aloud. His father Isaac answered him, Your dwelling will be away from the earth's riches, away from the dew of the heavens above. You will live by the sword, and you will serve your brother. But when you grow restless, you will throw his yoke from your neck. Esau held a grudge against Jacob because of the blessing his father had given him. He said to himself, The days of mourning for my father are near, and then I will kill my brother Jacob. When Rebekah was told what her older son Esau had said, she sent for her younger son Jacob and said to him, Your brother Esau is planning to avenge himself by killing you. Now then, my son, do what I say. Flee at once to my brother Laban in Haran. Stay with him for a while until your brother's fury subsides. And when your brother is no longer angry with you and forgets what you did to him, I'll send word for you to come back from there. Why should I lose both of you in one day? Then Rebekah said to Isaac, I am disgusted with living because of these Hittite women. If Jacob takes a wife from among the women of this land, from Hittite women like these, my life will not be worth living. Genesis 28. So Isaac called for Jacob and blessed him, and then he commanded him, Do not marry a Canaanite woman. Go at once to Paddan Aram, to the house of your mother's family in Bethuel. Take a wife for yourself there from among the daughters of Laban, each brother. And may God Almighty bless you and make you fruitful and increase your numbers until you become a community of peoples. And may He give you and your descendants the blessings given to Abraham, so that you may take possession of the land where you now reside as a foreigner, the land God gave to Abraham. And then Isaac sent Jacob on his way, and he went to Paddan Aram, to Laban's son of Bethuel the Aram, the brother of Rebekah, who was the mother of Jacob and Esau. Now Esau learned that Isaac had blessed Jacob and had sent him to Paddan Aram to take a wife from there, and that when he blessed him, he commanded him, "Do not marry a Canaanite woman," and that Jacob had obeyed his father and his mother and had gone to Paddan Aram. Esau then realized how displeasing the Canaanite women were to his father Isaac, and so he went to Ishmael and married Mahalath, the sister of Naboth and daughter of Ishmael, son of Abraham, in addition to the wives he already had. Jacob's dream of Bethel. Jacob left Beersheba and set out for Haran, and when he reached a certain place, he stopped for the night because the sun had set. Taking one of the stones there, he put it under his head and lie down to sleep. He had a dream in which he saw a stairway resting on the earth, with its top reaching to heaven, and the angels of God were ascending and descending on it. There above it stood the Lord, and he said, "I am the Lord, the God of your father Abraham, and the God of Isaac. I will give you and your descendants the land on which you are lying. Your descendants will be like the dust of the earth, and you will spread out to the west and to the east and to the north and to the south. All peoples on earth will be blessed through you and your offspring. I am with you and will watch over you wherever you go, and I will bring you back to this land. I will not leave you until I have done what I have promised you." And when Jacob awoke from his sleep, he thought, "Surely the Lord is in this place, and I was not aware of it." And he was afraid and said, "How awesome is this place! This is none other than the house of God. This is the gate of heaven." Early the next morning, Jacob took the stone that he had placed under his head, and he set it up as a pillar and poured oil on top of it. He called the place Bethel, though the city used to be called Luz. Then Jacob made a vow, saying, "If God will be with me and will watch over me on this journey I am taking, and will give me some food to eat and clothes to wear, and so that I return safely to my father's household, then the Lord will be my God, and this stone that I have set up as a pillar will be God's house. And of all that you give me, I will give you a tenth." That was Genesis 27 through 28. Now we will be turning to Matthew 8, 18 through 34. Matthew 8, the cost of following Jesus. Matthew 8, 18. When Jesus saw the crowd around him, he gave orders to cross to the other side of the lake. Then a teacher of the law came to him and said, "Teacher, I will follow you wherever you go." Jesus replied, "Foxes have dens and birds have nests, but the Son of Man has no place to lie his head." Another disciple said to him, "Lord, first let me go and bury my father." But Jesus told him, "Follow me and let the dead bury their own dead." Jesus calms the sea. Then he got into the boat and his disciples followed him. Suddenly a furious storm came up on the lake so that the waves swept over the boat. But Jesus was sleeping. The disciples went and woke him, saying, "Lord, save us. We are going to drown." He replied, "You of little faith, why are you so afraid?" Then he got up and rebuked the winds and the waves, and it was completely calm. The men were amazed, and they asked, "What kind of man is this? Even the winds and the waves obey him." Jesus restores two demon-possessed men. When he arrived at the other side in the region of Gadarenes, two demon-possessed men, coming down from the tombs, met him. They were so violent that no one could pass that way. "What do you want with us, Son of God?" they shouted. "Have you come here to torture us before an appointed time?" Some distance from them, a large herd of pigs was feeding. The demons begged Jesus, "If you drive us out, send us into the herd of pigs." He said then to them, "Then go." And so they came out and they went into the pigs. And the whole herd rushed down the steep embankment into the lake, and they died in the water. Those tending to the pigs ran off, went to the town, and reported all this, including what had happened to the demon-possessed men. Then the whole town went out to meet Jesus, and when they saw him, they pleaded with him to leave their region. And that was Matthew 8:18 through 34, which concludes the Bible with Briscoe 2024 for today. Tomorrow we will be covering Genesis 29 through 30 and Matthew 9:1 through 17. Father, I just thank you for your word, because if it were not for your word, I would not be able to be your messenger of the word. And so I give you all the praise and all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. And they all said, amen. I'd like to thank you folks for tuning into the Bible with Briscoe 2024 for today. I, Shenandoah Briscoe, have enjoyed being your messenger of the Word of God. And as always, God loves you, so do I. So come back and see us tomorrow, because God willing, we'll be here. Goodbye, God bless you, and please like and share.